a preview of winter's stars in August.
Hey there, stargazers. I'm Marlene Hidalgo, science teacher from Miami, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas from Cincinnati, Ohio.
And I'm James Alberry from Gainesville, Florida. Let's show you when and where to look so you can get a preview in the sultry skies of August of the brightest stars of winter.
Plus, the moon pays a visit to two morning planets to close out the month.
While Venus and Saturn put on a show in the evening sky, let's show you. Okay, we've got our sky set up for Monday next week about 45 minutes before sunrise facing east, where you'll see several bright stars covering a huge area from east to southeast.
Looking south of east, you'll easily see winter's super bright star just above the southeast horizon. It's the brightest star in the night sky, Sirius, the brightest star of Canis Major, Orion's big hunting dog.
Up to Sirius's left is Procyon, which marks the eye of Orion's little dog.
And above and to Procyon's right, completing a triangle of bright stars, is Betelgeuse, the bright red shoulder of Orion.
Down to the right of Betelgeuse are the unmistakable three stars, evenly spaced in a row, which mark the belt of winter's Orion himself. His two knee stars, Rigel and Safe, to the right, and his two shoulder stars, Betelgeuse and Bellatrix, to the left.
And directly above his shoulder stars lies Aldebaran, the reddish star, which marks the eye of Taurus the bull. And to Taurus's left, Capella, the brightest star of winter's Auriga, the charioteer. And directly below him, Castor and Pollux, the two brightest stars of Gemini the twins.
So, even though nights may still be hot and sultry where you live at the end of August, every August, if you get out just before sunrise, you can see many of the brightest stars of winter climbing above the eastern horizon.
But this year, something has been added, because directly between Castor and Pollux and Orion, you'll see an additional bright light, a wandering star, which usually isn't there. You'll be looking over 500 million miles across the solar system at the giant planet Jupiter.
This is a good opportunity to use a small telescope and take a good look at Jupiter. Its moons will be there for you to see, and even the great red spot should be well placed for you to see. Since it's still early morning, the air will be comparatively cool and steady, so you should get a good view of the king of the planets.
Closer to the horizon and directly in line with Castor and Pollux, looking like a third brother in Gemini, is the reddish planet Mars. Mars is much closer to us than Jupiter, but it's still more than twice as far away as the Sun, over 200 million miles away.
And, as always, may I remind you that whenever we look for Mars, we need to remember that Mars is only half the size of our Earth. So you'll be looking at a very small planet that's very far away. Now, if you watch both these planets through the end of August, you'll notice that Jupiter gets a little bit higher above the horizon each day, while Mars will get farther below Jupiter each day.
And if you have trouble telling a planet from a star, here's a tip. You can use the moon at August's end as a finder. On Saturday, August 31st, an old crescent moon will be parked very close to Jupiter. And 2 days later, on Monday the 2nd, an extremely slender crescent moon will rise right below Mars.
And if you've got a really clear, flat, cloudless horizon on Tuesday, September 3rd, you may see one of the skinniest moons you'll ever see farther below Mars, just above the horizon.
So, there you have it. All of winter's bright stars visible in the east just before sunrise at August's end. Procyon, Sirius, and Betelgeuse mark the winter triangle. Betelgeuse and Rigel, Safe and Bellatrix mark the giant hunter Orion, and above them lie Aldebaran and the V-shape of Taurus, plus Castor and Pollux, and Jupiter and Mars.
And if you can't get up before dawn to see this preview of winter, never fear, because we have saved two evening planets for you.
Look west after the sun goes down, and brilliant Venus, and not quite so bright Saturn, will be easily found in the skies at sunset.
Keep looking up.